guys, thanks for tuning in. So today I have the SwellPro here, the splash drone, and it comes with 5200 milliamp hour batteries that last between 15 and 20 minutes. This is an 8000 milliamp battery and it's a higher voltage. It is a 4S, but these are the newer higher voltage batteries that this should be able to handle it no problem. I went ahead and just plugged it in and there was no problems, but I haven't flown with this yet. I've got it fully charged and I want to see if we can get some more flight time with this larger battery. So just going to initially boot it up and put it in the air, and then I'll just kind of fast forward and show you how long this thing flies for with the Multistar 8000 mAh lithium high voltage. Now before we fly, I just thought I'd mention that this thing is no easy task to get in here. So you've kind of got to really wedge it in, and I'm not sure how good it is for the drone, but you've got to push the lead side in there, and then you can see how it just barely fits over these electronics, and you've got to kind of slide it back in while you're pushing it in. This is just for, you know, test purposes, just to see if it's at all possible. There we go. So I got it slid in there. I want to make sure the leads are out before we wedge this thing in, so you can see how incredibly tight that thing is in there. But it does fit, so you see that? So it's fitting. We can go ahead and strap it. I'm not gonna have much room to strap, just barely anything actually. Maybe it won't even strap. Yeah, so this actually won't even strap. So if I wanted to use this, I'm gonna have to get a longer strap. But I think it'll be okay just for hovering in the air without it being strapped in. So we'll just go ahead and try that. Okay, so I've got everything on. Just gonna go ahead and make sure I have enough satellites. We got 20 satellites on here. I'm not putting any FPV, or I'm not even recording the GoPro camera on the drone, because I just wanna do a flight time test. So, and even see if it can handle hovering or flying with it a little bit. So just gonna do that. So everything's good. I'll switch this to the top and we're gonna arm by going in and down. There we go. So we're armed. Let's see if it can even lift up with this thing. It does, just barely. Seems like it's a little bit too heavy for its altitude hold though, kinda. See how it's coming down. A little bit of fluctuating. Forgot to start the timer. So I'm gonna go ahead and start that timer there. Let's see how it does. Okay, so actually it kind of found its altitude. It's a little windy today, but it is working. So I'm just gonna time it here and kind of fast forward. It looks like it will fly. I'll go ahead and feel the motors when we're all done, just to see how hot they are. But just gonna kind of let it fly and see how long it lasts. All right, cool, so far so good. It's been about 10, almost 11 minutes now, 10:45, and everything's a-okay. The only thing I'm seeing is its usual fluctuation from its altitude, the barometer. So nothing major going on here. It's doing great. Still got 15.4 volts to it. This is that higher voltage battery, so let's just see how long it lasts. I'm just gonna have it hover here until it beeps at me. I'll let you know when the controller starts beeping for a low voltage warning, and then we'll just let it go until it finally goes ahead and does its low voltage automatic landing. This is a good example too of how good it is in the wind. It's about almost 2 o'clock here PM and the wind's really picked up from this direction. It's coming this way, like maybe 15 to 20 at times, and it can fight it. So doing really good. All right, so we hit 15 minutes here on the watch and we're at 14.9 volts, 15 volts on the telemetry here. Still got 19 to 20 GPS satellites. And it's doing great, not getting any toilet bowl effect or anything. I didn't even recalibrate the compass for this larger battery and it seems to be handling it fine. What I did want to make sure of, this has a lower C rating. I think the batteries they give you are like 20 to 25 C, but this one's a 10 C Multistar. So I just want to see how it is if we punch it. So I'm just gonna do a punch up and see if it can actually lift and survive if it's got enough amperage. So Just gonna let it hover down low again. It's kind of doing its up and down altitude and punching now. Yeah, so it picks up speed. I mean, it picks up altitude. It's not entirely fast. I don't really see a difference from the other battery. Maybe a little more sluggish. There's more weight. Seems to be doing fine though. Cool. So going on 16 minutes and 20 seconds. With one of the batteries, I only got about 15 minutes. And the other battery, I actually got 20 minutes about when I was in the water and stuff. Probably because I was dropping in the water and sitting there for a while. Okay guys, so we just hit 20 minutes on the watch. And we're at 14.6 volts, 14.7 volts on the screen here, the telemetry screen on the controller. And the wind's kind of kicked up even a few more miles per hour. It's got to be like around 15 to 20, 20 something with gusts. And we're still hovering. I'm listening to the controller. I got no low voltage warning beep yet. And I'm just going to keep on going. It's doing pretty good. We are getting that fluctuation. So this is where we may see, you know, some issues with the low C rating amperage, but it seems like it's okay. It's just been hovering here. All I did is that one punch up, and it's just trying to fight that wind. You can see how it's, I'm not even touching it, and it's kind of doing this down, forward, and up type of deal just to fight the wind a little bit. But let's just see how far it'll go. Okay, so I just got the first couple of beeps on the low voltage warning at 24 minutes and 30 seconds. Just occasionally beeping, and I'm feeling the vibration at like 14.3. It looks like it kicks in that initial one. So it's fluctuating between 14.4 and 14.3. And 14.3 is when it's warning. So, man, that's 25 minutes. So that's great. So I'm just gonna keep letting it go. It's stayed locked right in its position. It's just been doing the altitude thing, but it's pretty well locked. Moving around just like a foot or so. I'm gonna bring it back just to be safe a little bit. So when it does land, it's not gonna land in those bushes. So it's not giving me a constant beep, but it's giving me an occasional warning. And it's doing really good in the wind. So 25 minutes, 40 seconds. Okay, so the warning is staying on a little more. So I'll go ahead and check back in. Whoa, okay, that was weird. So I landed and it took back off. I'm gonna just pick it up a little bit. Whoa. But probably a good idea to land it now because it's, can't really trust it this point. So it wanted to land at like 26 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and just land it because it's hopping up and down or pulling down on the stick there. The motors go all the way off. Well, cool. So that was a great test. Let me stop it here. So about 26 minutes until it's gonna want to land on that multi-star 8,000 milliamp hour battery. Really quick, checking the motors. Not even warm, still cold, wow. I mean, the wind is really helping that because it's, the wind is cooling them really easy. Let me go ahead and pop this cover off real quick and see how hot the battery is. Okay, so opening up, nothing's puffed up. Battery is only normally, it's just kind of its normal like the other stock batteries are. You know, slightly warm, a little warmer than, you know, warm, but, you know, medium warm to hot, but not hot enough to where it's really noticeable. That's kind of normal. So, wow, guys, so super impressed. 26 minutes until it's going to want to kind of force land hop. But I hope that helps you out and, you know, gives you an idea of what this thing can handle. I was really anxious to try this, and it seems to be able to take it. So, as you can see, I'm on the shoreline in the ocean. I had another journey looking for a shark, and I found a turtle and was watching some fish under the water as part of the review. Go ahead and check those videos out if you haven't seen those. But the next one's gonna be, I have that fisherman kit. So I'm gonna pop that fisherman kit on the bottom. It just goes right underneath here. You take off this gimbal and camera, and the fisherman kit has a fixed camera with a payload release mechanism. And I'm gonna go ahead and take some fishing line out and see how it works with that. Drop some weight and slide some bait down and try to do some fishing. So anyway, guys, I hope you like this video. I will have the multi-star battery, the splash drone, and everything I'm using here down in the description. So if you are interested in this stuff, go ahead and check down there below the video, see what the current pricing is and more in-depth specs, and do this with your splash drone. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.